Greetings, Freddy. Welcome to another session of Cyber Law and Ethics. My name is Mohammad Rahmatali. So in today's session, we are going to learn about information system ethics. But before we start our today's topic, let me revise what are the things that we have studied in the previous session. We studied about information and ethics, law and ethics with reference to information system. Also, we studied about the different methods by which it has been applied and what are the mechanisms by which it has been used to implement it. So, in today's session, we are going to learn about information system ethics. So, what do you mean by this? It says, ethics refers to rules of right and wrong that people use to make choice to guide their behavior. Ethics in MIS seeks to protect and safeguard individual and society by using information system responsibly. Now, most professionals usually have defined a code of ethics or code of conduct guidelines that all professionals affiliated with that profession must adhere to. Now, further it says, in a nutshell, a code of ethics makes individual acting on their free will responsible and accountable for their actions. An example of code of ethics for MIS professional can be found on the British Computer System website. Now this is with reference to the general information, with reference to the information system and ethics. Now what it further says, ethical component in information system. Now what it says over here is, information technology specifies two components that are used to store, fetch and manipulate the information at the minimum level, with the server having an operating system. Further, information technology have a wide area of application in education, business, health, industries, banking sector and scientific research at a large level. Now, further, with the leading advancement in information technology, it is necessary to have the knowledge of security issues, privacy issues and main negative impact of information technology. To deal with these issues in IT society, it is important to find out ethical issues. So what are the ethical issues? Some of the major ethical issues faced by information technologies are personal privacy, access right, harmful action, patents, copyrights, trade secrets, liabilities and piracy. So this is the thing that we are going to study in today's session. Now, what is personal privacy? It says it is an important aspect of ethical issue in information technology. Now, what actually do you mean by personal privacy? Personal privacy, in a sense, it means it is important aspect with reference to ethical issues for information technology. In the sense, one's personal information and privacy should be protected in any of the form being there. Whether it might be in the form of data, whether it might be in the form of photograph, whether it might be in the form of video, or whether it might be in the form of digital footprint that he or she has left behind. So this need to be protected. So what it says further, IT facilitates the users having their own hardware, operating system and software tool to access the server that are connected to each other and to the user by the network. In a sense, the system that we are using and the hardware and the software that we are using and right now to access any of the website, that particular website or that particular server should see that the privacy of that particular user is being maintained. For instance, if I want to see what are the people who are accessing google.com or yahoo.com or gmail.com or any of the website, so that particular server should not give me the user details. For example, what is the name of the user and what is what are the recent website that he has visited and like the other things. But the only information that you will be getting after a lot of efforts is the MAC address by which it is being using. So to reduce that also, VPNs are being used to divert the MAC address and the IP address by which you are accessing that particular information. Now, further it says, due to the distribution of the network on a large scale, data or information transfer in big amount takes place, which leads to the hidden chances of disclosing information and violating the privacy of any individual or a group. Now what do you mean by this? The best example I can give you for this particular thing is, in your Google Drive, you store a lot of photographs, videos, and all of things, or you synchronize your gallery with the Google Drive so that all of the information should be stored online. Now, it's the responsibility of Google or the people who are providing the services should protect the data. That data should not be leaked online or anywhere else. And it is the responsibility of that particular server to protect the data. And also, that particular server should also not use that particular data for its own personal use. This is also one of the things. So whenever the bulk data or individual data is been uploaded or downloaded, or it is been transferred from one place to another place, it is a responsibility of the person, or it is the responsibility of the service provider, to see that no data is being breached, no data is been compromised, or no data is been disclosed to anyone in any form. Also, like for example, like, you know, when you are having a conversation, if at all if you are taking a screenshot and you are put on just saving on your drive, the chances of that particular conversation getting leaked is very high, very much high. So for an instance, I'm telling you all of this things to get you an idea of what actually it is. Now further it says, it is a major challenge for IT society and organization to maintain the privacy and integrity of the data. The integrity and privacy of the data should be maintained. In the sense, who created the data, when the data was being created, when the data was being altered, how the files is gathering information, XYZ type of information, all of the things should not be disclosed to anyone. It should be maintained. Now the last point it says is, accidental disclosure to inappropriate individual and provisions to protect the accuracy of data also comes in privacy issues. Now if at all the data is being leaked, so what are the compensation the company will be giving, or what are the things that other things for compensation or other remedial things to retrieve the data so that it should not happen, what are the things at all things, it all comes under this personal privacy. Now further it says, with reference to the access right, with reference to the access right, in the sense, who is allowed to access that particular data, or who is allowed to gain the access to the data, that is very important. For instance, if I tell you, with reference to the access right, correcting the papers and giving the marks is my access right. Altering or on request changing the marks is with reference to the head of the department. Head of the department has got the access right whether to increase or decrease the marks. It is my personal right to correct the papers and give the accurate marks with reference to the answers given by the students. So this is with reference to the access right. What it says, the second aspect of ethical issue in information technology is the access right. So what is access right? Access right becomes a higher priority issue for the IT and cyberspace with the great advancement in technology. E-commerce and electronic payment system evolution on the internet heightened this issue for various corporate organizations and government agencies. Now what do you mean by this? For example, you are having a bank, you can pay everything with reference to the bank and directly from the bank, but still you are using third party apps. For example, Google Pay, Paytm, or whatever the payment app it has. Why you are using this particular information, this particular application? So that it gives you an easier access to give the payment. But what is the authentication that this particular third party apps will not leak your bank details to anyone? What is the possibility? The possibility of this particular thing depends on the service provider. Recently, many of the Paytm database was been hacked and many of the information was being leaked. And apart from that, many of the other e-commerce websites has been hacked, and that particular database is being leaked on internet. Recently, if you see with reference to the Air India things and with reference to the Domino's, all of this personal data, with like approximately about 7 terabyte of data, was being leaked on dark web. And apart from dark web, this particular information is being sold online now for free of cost. So this is the level to which the information access right is being breached. Further, it says network on the internet cannot be made secure from unauthorized access. Now this is very difficult part. If like see, for every other thing there is some of the loopholes which is been there. Nothing has been perfect. So to make it perfect, we are making a different tries to make it more secure, more perfect, and more secure with reference to the unauthorized access. Now the last point it says, generally the intrusion detection system are used to determine whether the user is an intruder or an appropriate user. Now there is something called as intrusion detection system. What do you mean by intrusion detection system? And there is something called as intrusion prevention system. Now what do you mean by these two things? Intrusion detection system will detect the unauthorized user, whereas intrusion prevention system will not allow unauthorized access to enter into the system. Whereas it will detect and it will prevent. Detection and prevention are two different things. Prevention will not allow from any of the instances, but detection might allow at some instance, but it will try to avoid. With reference to intrusion detection system, it might be attacked, but with reference to intrusion prevention system, the chances of getting attacked is very, very low. Now with reference to intrusion detection system, with reference to the access right, it will allow only accessed users. For example, you belong to ISL Engineering College. Can some other person from other college can enter and write the exam as an internal exam in our college? No, why? Because with reference to the roll number, I can identify, or the examiner can identify, that this person does not belong to our college. The college code that has been given is not matching with our college code. So we will not allow that particular person to write the internal examination in our college. With reference to the external examination, we will see the center code. If at all the center code matches with our center, then only we'll be allowing that particular person to write the exam in our college. So this is with reference to the access right. Now with reference to the harmful information or harmful action that has been taken, this particular thing is being evolved. Like, what are the different harmful actions that can be taken with reference to WOM, with reference to the Trojan horse, with reference to the malicious code being added to some of the files, or exploitable things. So what it says, harmful actions in the computer ethics refers to the damage or negative consequences to the IT such as a loss of important information, loss of property, loss of ownership, destruction of property, and undesirable substantial impact. This can be with reference to worms, this can be with reference to the Trojan horses, this can be with reference to adding malicious code, this can be with reference to the ransomware, this can be with reference to the hacking, this can be with reference to any of the things created online. So these are some of the harmful actions. So what it does to the loss of important information, such as loss of property, loss of ownership, destruction of property, and undesirable things. Next point it says, this principle of ethical conduct restricts any outsider from the use of information technology in manner which leads to any loss to any of the users, employers, and the general public. The same thing that I have said you. The next point it says, typically these action compromises of the international destruction or alteration of files in program which drives serious loss of resources. Now this means this action will compromise the laws and ethics of that particular community or that particular organization. For example, a person is trying to access about this salary information of different employee so that he can compare and he can ask for a hike in the company. So this is not with reference to the policy of the company, but still he is trying to access that particular information. So this is with reference to the intentional destruction or alteration of files with reference to the loss of resources. Now the last point it says is, to recover from harmful action, extra time and extra efforts are required to remove the viruses from the computer system. As obvious, it says, like when a new attack or a new breach has been taken, it takes time to remove that particular virus. With reference to the recent pandemic, we can understand it takes time to make vaccine. In the same way, it takes time to make an antivirus. It takes time to remove the viruses from the system. Now, further, it says with reference to the patents. Now, what do you mean by this patent? Patent is an individual property which has been designed, defined by an individual. No other person can use that particular thing without the permission. If at all, if you are using that particular thing, you need to pay the royalty for that particular product or for that particular things. Now, what it says, it is more difficult to deal with these type of ethical issues. A patent can preserve the unique and secret aspect of an idea. Obtaining a patent is very difficult as compared with obtaining a copyright. Now, patent and copyright is two different things. Patent in the sense, I have developed a new idea with reference to a particular thing. But in sense, if I tell you, with reference to the antiviruses or with reference to the firewalls, I have created a new technology. So that remains a patent for me. Whereas with reference to copyright in the sense, with reference to an existing idea, I have improvised that particular thing. That is what we call like a copyright of everything. Or you have created a content and that content has been copied by someone. The same thing has been written and same thing has been done. So that is what we call as a copyright. Also, with reference to a major project or mini project, when you go for this particular called as plagiarism, there you will see how many percent you have copied from internet. That it will show. That is with reference to the copyrights. Now, the next point it says, a thorough disclose is required with reference to the software if anything has been copied, and also with reference to what you call as Unix, Linux, and with reference to Windows. Unix, Linux are open source. You can develop your own operating system based on Unix and Linux. Based on that particular thing, you can develop your own thing. With reference to this Windows, you can use that particular application. You cannot make an alternative with reference to Windows. So this is a major difference between the patent and copyrights. The next one is with reference to the patent. The patent holder has to reveal the full details of a program to a proficient programmer for building a program. Now, what do you mean by this? See, when I have developed my own genuine idea, I will have all of the depth and width of that particular application. So I'll provide all of this information. If at all, if I'm not sure with reference to the patents, then I will not be providing all of this information. Though then I cannot make that particular thing as a patent on my particular name. Okay. You also can make many of the patents. With reference to World Wide Web, this has not been patent. If at all that would have been patent, you could not have been using this particular internet now. With reference to different things, HTTPS, with reference to World Wide Web, there are many of the things which has not been patent. If at all that would have been patent, we could not have been using this particular internet. Like, I would not be recording this particular session and putting on online, and you would not been in a position of seeing this particular lecture on that particular platform. Okay, now this is with reference to the patents. Now, with reference to the copyrights, the second part of patent is a copyright, which says the information security specialists are to be familiar with necessary concept of the copyright laws. Now, copyright laws works as a powerful legal tool in protecting computer software both before a security breach and surely after a security breach. Now, this type of breach could be mishandling and misuse of data, computer program, documentation and similar materials. In many countries, copyright legislation is amended or revised to provide explicit law to protect computer programs. Now, what do you mean by this? See, if I tell you with a common understanding and common sense, a person who is developing an application for a bank, he has a framework of developing this particular thing. He or she has a framework of developing the things. The basic transaction of any of the bank is withdrawal, deposit, showing balance, and maintaining a minimum balance. It's all of the things will be maintained in every of the bank. But the only difference in one bank to another bank is the service provided by that particular bank. That's the major difference between all of these things. So the framework or the things remain the same. In this way, I cannot say that this bank has copied that particular thing or that bank has copied this particular thing. So copyright is a different thing and making your own thing is a different thing. But if at all one bank is copying the same platform or same what you call as gateway of payment, then that will be considered as a copyright. Now the next one is with reference to trade secrets. With reference to trade secrets, trade secret is also a significant ethical issue in information technology. A trade secret is something of value and usefulness. For example, what is my business, how my business is working, and how the other things are been done. Like with reference to the KFC, McDonald's, how they make the burger, and with reference to the Paradise, how they make biryani. These all are the secrets, the trade secret that they have. They will be storing this particular thing on different platform and different ways. So this should be protected. The next is with reference to this law protects the private aspect of idea, which is known only to the discovery or the confidence. Like I have told you with reference to Coca-Cola, KFC, McDonald's and all of the things. Once disclosed, the trade secret is lost as such and only protected by the law for trade secrets. Now the last point it says, the application of trade secret law is very broad in computer range, where even a slight head start in the advancement of software or hardware can put a significant competitive influence. So this is with reference to the trade secrets. The next one is with reference to liability. It says one should be aware of the liability issue in making ethical decisions. Software developer makes promises and assertions to the user about the nature and quality of the product that can be restricted as an expresses and as a warranty. Now next one it says, programmer or retailer possesses the legitimate to determine the express warranties. Thus, they have to be practical when they define any claim and prediction about the capacities, qualities and nature of their software or hardware. Now next one it says, every word they say about their product must or may be legally valid as stated in written. Last one it says is with reference to all agreements should be written to protect against the liabilities. A disclaimer of express warranties can free a supplier from being held responsible of informal speculative statement or forecasting made during the agreement stages. Now the last one is with reference to the piracy. Now with reference to the piracy, you know a lot about privacy more than me, like with reference to the movie download, with reference to copying a similar thing, with reference to the using of duplication of operating system, etc. type of things. Now it says, piracy is an activity in which the creation of illegal copy of the software is made. It is entirely up to the owner of the software as to whether or not user can make backup copies of their software. As laws made for copyright protection are evolving, also legislation that would stop unauthorized duplication of software is in consideration. Now next it says, the software industry is prepared to do encounter against software piracies. Now what do you mean by this? Like you have different platforms, like this is the reason torrent has been disabled. If at all you are using torrent, will be held as a cyber you are creating a cyber crime if at all you are using torrent. The next one is with reference to the court are dealing with an increasing number of actions concerning the production of software. So this is with reference to the piracy. I hope you understood something from today's session. If at all you have any doubt with reference to today's session, please ping me at ramadan_ali@yahoo.com, or you can have a doubt clarification session in the days coming soon. Thank you for listening in today's session. See you in the next session. Thank you.